Hi, good morning friends. Today we are going to discuss about the family Cassiopeiaceae BSc second year students, for BSc second year students of the botany. So Cassiopeiaceae family included the large group of the leguminaceae, and here I have taken an example of Cassia fistula and it is included in your syllabus. So this is the plant of Cassia fistula, showing the yellow flowers. So we'll discuss about this Cassiopeiaceae or Cassiopeiaceae family. Cassiopeiaceae or Cassiopeiaceae is a botanical name at the rank of the subfamily. It is placed in the large family of Fabaceae or Leguminaceae. Its name is formed from the generic name Cassiopeina. It is also known as the peacock flower subfamily. So let's see the classification, scientific classification. Cassiopeiaceae is a botanical name of the rank of the subfamily and it is included in the group of the Fabaceae or Leguminaceae. Now we have started to see the classification of this Cassiopeiaceae or Cassiopeinodiae. Division: Spermatophyta, subdivision Angiospermy, class Dicotyledons, subclass Polypetali, means showing the free petals, series Calciflora, order Fabales, and family Leguminaceae or Fabaceae, and subfamily Cassiopeiaceae or Cassiopeiaceae. Distribution of this family, it consists of about 152 genera and 2300 of the species. Vegetative characters: habit, trees, shrubs or rarely herb also. Root is the tap root and branched. Stem is herbaceous, woody or bipinnate. Now let's see the floral character. Inflorescence here, racemos or spike. The calyx, accessory floral whorl of the plant, consist of generally sepals 5. These are free or sometimes conate. Odd sepal anterior, imbricate aestivation. In tamarindus, the two posterior sepals are united. Corolla, there are 5 petals. In tamarinds, there are only 3 posterior petals. In Copaifera saraca, the petals are totally reduced. Free, ascending imbricate aestivation, posterior petal is innermost. Now let us see the androecium. Stamens are 10. Free, reduction in the number of stamens by the formation of staminodes. In Cassia, there are 3 posterior staminodes. Serica, 3 to 8 stamens. In Tamarindus, only 3 stamens and monodelphus. Diathecies and intros. Now let us discuss about the gynoecium. Gynoecium is monocarpally, showing single lobule. Oris superior, slightly inferior, unilocular with marginal placentation, straight or curved, hairy, style is long and stigma is simple. Now let's discuss about the fruit. Legumes: never break up into a seeded part. Seed is non-endospermic and pollination is the entomophilus, is with the help of the insect. The flower buds of Bonia variegata, that is the conchon, are used in as a vegetable. The fruit of tamarind indica are spicy and used as a condiments. The seeds of tamarind indica yield starch. It is also used in a medicinal purpose. The pulp of the pods of cassia fistula, that is amaltas, is utilized as a purgative. The bark decoction of the Seraca indica is used in as a remedy for the menstrual disorder. Then it is also used as a fiber. The bark of the Bonia yields fiber, which are used in a rope making. It is also useful in dye. The wood of Hematoxylon yields a dye called as hematoxylin. This is an anatomical stain. It is also useful in tanning, that is the pods of Cassiopeia is useful in making tanning leather. And Gulmohar, Bonia species are also used as a ornamental plants. So this is the floral diagram: androecium, gynoecium, then twig and flower of the family Cassiopeiaceae, Cassia fistula. Floral diagram along with the floral formula too. So friends, thank you.